What's up my friends, welcome back to the channel for a new video. First of all, I want to tell my apologies to some brands who sent me some drones to review, but I haven't had the time to do it because a lot of things have changed in my life, so it's a bit complicated, but I will do my best now to make video more often like before. I'm just sorry about that, but you know, with this pandemic and other things in my life, it's a bit complicated actually. In today's video, we're gonna talk about the drone that I used to make this cinematic video. I hope you have enjoyed it, guys. And this drone is the iFlight Camera 4 Long Range HD. It's a 4-inch FPV quads who is running the Kydex Vista and a naked GoPro. It's a sub 250-gram quads without the GoPro on it, so I don't know with the naked GoPro, but I think you're not that far with a naked GoPro. You can fly it with a full GoPro and you can use a cable from iFlight to remove the battery from your GoPro, connect it to the battery and in the USB port of your GoPro. That way it's so much lighter. When you buy it, you can choose to buy it with the original camera of the Kydex Vista or the Nebula camera. I recommend you the original camera because the quality is so much better. For the motors, you can also choose two different ones. You got the 3000 kV motors, they call that Black Cruiser, which is more for cruising flight, and you can also choose the 3800 kV motors and they call it Black Speed Cruiser, which is, I think, more for if you want to make tricks or things like that. Mine are the 3800 kV motors and I'm really happy with them. This quad is also very, very light, which is great and can be a downside too. The drone is also very, very quiet, which is something insane. More quiet than a Mavic 2 Pro, for example, except if you put full throttle on it. Of course, it's gonna make a lot of noise, but other than that, when you're just cruising, it's more silent than a Mavic, which is insane. The tune of this quad is also perfect. Like always with iFlight BNF drone, I never have to complain about that. They're just flying so smoothly and this one is not an exception. The tune is just perfect. On this drone, you're gonna get a GPS, which is a must-have for long-range quads. This GPS is working really great. Maybe the first time you're gonna turn on the drone, you're gonna need to wait a few minutes, but when you put the second battery, you're gonna have GPS right away, so it's perfect. And inside the box, you can find a notice who explain you how to configure your GPS. And you can also find a link in description from iFlight who explain you the same how to configure your GPS. So it's perfect. And to be honest, it's working so, so good. My version is with the X bottom plate, but you can order this dead cat plate. It's not included inside the package, but you can order it. Apparently it's better for long range, but to be honest, like this, I never had to complain about it. I went to like 2 kilometers away or a little bit more. So For me it's fine, but apparently if you want better long range, it's better to have the dead cat plate. And by the way, here is what you get if you buy this drone inside the box. Like always with iFly, they give you everything that you need. They give you some spare of props, some spare of battery straps, and even some battery pads. So you have everything that you need inside. And for those of you who are interested in detailed specs, here are the detailed specs. But I think most of you guys just want to know if this FPV is flying great and if it's good for you and what you need to do. For me, to be honest, it's the only thing who counts when I receive a drone: if it's flying great, if it's smooth, if I can do what I want to do with it. That's it. For the batteries, I use the Tattoo Airline batteries, the 850mAh batteries mostly, and also the 650mAh batteries, the one that I use with my Beta FPV for example, and they work really great. With the 850mAh I can fly like 6 minutes, and as you saw in the video, I went pretty high and pretty far. For me it's just perfect. I use mostly the 850mAh, but also with the 650 I were able to go on top of the mountains. So 650 or 850, you're just gonna be able to fly a little bit less with the 650, but it's not a huge difference. And I'm sure that if you're just cruising in a seaside for example, or really open field, but you don't need to go really high, so you don't need to push the throttle, you can clearly fly 8 minutes without any problem. To record my videos with this quad, I use my naked GoPro, but you can also use the SMO4K, also a full GoPro. Like I said, you just need to remove the battery and use a cable from iFly to connect here, and then you can provide the GoPro like that. But I recommend you to use a naked or the SMO4K. Just need to solder two cables here on the flight controller, and that's it. For the filters, I use the FreeWell filters, the same that I use with my SMO4K and my Beta FPV 95X version 3, and they are really perfect because inside the box you have ND4, 8, 16, 32 PL and 64 PL plus one CPL filter. Perfect for every conditions, and you can adjust the PL version. If you're flying over water, it's perfect to remove reflections. And the CPL ones can be used to protect the lens, and you can also adjust it because it's a CPL. Thank you FreeWell, because the result is perfect. I have no vignetting, nothing wrong, so they are the one that I recommend to you for naked GoPro or SMO4K. They work just perfectly, you have all the range, it's perfect. And by the way, if you don't know how to make a naked GoPro, you can find two different tutorials in descriptions. The first one is how to make a GoPro naked, and the second one is how to put everything inside the Beta FPV naked GoPro case. Also, GoPro have changed their app. Now you can't adjust your manual settings inside the GoPro app, so you need to do a trick for this. And if you want to know how to do that, you can go to my Instagram, check out my reels. I've made a tutorial about how to do this trick. You need to use two different apps. It's not free, but it's the best way for now to set your manual settings on your naked GoPro. There is three things that I don't like about this quad. The first one is the weight. Because the quad is really light, it's specific for me, but I'm flying in high altitude. There is a lot of wind sometimes, and two times it happened when I was diving a mountain that it started to put full throttle. I think it's the air mod on the FPV. The drone was starting to fly like a balloon in the air. So yeah, the weight of this quad, it can be a downside. It depends on what you want to do with it. But when I was inside these mountains for the video, it was not that much windy and it was perfect. So it's just to let you know, if it's really windy, it's not ideal to fly with a light drone like that. The second thing is this. As you can see, the bottom plate is one part. That means if you crash and if you break an arm, you can't change it. You need to change all the bottom plates, which is not that great in my opinion, but when you're just cruising and making long range, you're not crashing very often, except if you take some risk. But yeah, it's a bit of a downside for me that you need to change all the bottom plates if you break an arm. And the last point is the fact that there is no TPU mount included inside the box for naked GoPro, for full GoPro, or anything. But I can understand, because they don't know which camera you're gonna use. And they can provide to you all the TPUs, like naked GoPros, SMO 4K, full GoPros. Like I said, you can find a lot of different TPU for all the cameras in some shops. For the price, it's $275 if you use the DJI controller, and it's $304 if you want the TBS version like mine if you use Crossfire. Do I recommend this drone for you? Yes, if you're a beginner or not. It's really great because you can do proxy flights or long range flights, so it's a good all-in-one solution. You have this huge antenna who looks like an excited dick, but the reception is insane with it. I highly recommend you this quad, even if you're not a beginner, but if you're a beginner and you want to buy your first FPV, it can be really great. If you have a Tango 2, for example, it takes really less space inside your backpack because the batteries are a lot more smaller than the one that I use for my 5-inch, for example. To have the GPS included, it's also great because if you're starting FPV or not, it can be scared to go far. So having this security with the GPS, and like I said, the GPS is working really great, it's always good to have. That's it for today, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give a thumbs up if you like the video, subscribe to support my channel, hit that bell to receive a notification for my next video, and I hope my next video is gonna be really soon. Thank you guys for watching, wish you all the best, take care, and I see you soon. Salut.